Our research is about allowing us to use a sense of touch in virtual reality. Imagine you're a surgeon operating on a virtual organ. You can see that organ, but how can you feel it? We've developed soft, active surfaces with bumps that can move up and down. These bumps are a few millimeters on the side, and they can move up slowly or fast or vibrate. And one special thing about our device is that they can not only push against the skin, but they can also stretch the skin. It's the stretching of the skin that gives us a lot of information. And our devices can push in plane and out of plane, and thus give a very rich sensation of haptic feedback.
To make our actuators, we first start with a metallized polymer membrane that we laser cut, and then we stack and bond layers together to form cavities. These cavities are covered with a stretchable membrane, and we fill them with dielectric fluid, vegetable oil, for example. And then when you apply a voltage to the metallized membrane, what you observe is that the electrodes come together, and then the dielectric fluid is pushed into the center of the actuator, and it deforms the stretchable membrane that pushes onto your finger. This is a unique features compared to what exists in terms of technologies today.
So far, we've made our active bumps in size from 3 millimeters up to 20 millimeters, and with arrays up to 25 devices. That allows us to wrap them very nicely on a fingertip, allowing us to feel rich haptic sensation on a finger. Now, the next step is to put it into a glove, and if you're wearing a virtual reality headset, you can then imagine that you are playing a video game, as shown in Ready Player One, or you're a surgeon and you're training for a specific task and you need to use your sense of touch. But since our gloves are so very thin, you can also use them without the VR headset and use them, for instance, for learning how to play an instrument or improve your sports playing. Now, to reach these applications, we have to incorporate our devices into a glove and over the fingertip and eventually over the whole hand to give this delicate sense of touch.